You know, that has been a major point of criticism of this this president and this administration, has been this notion that he has not been the kind of president that would come out and, for example, go into a marketplace and relate with Nigerians or talk to Nigerians.
Not necessarily. Not necessarily.
But the question I want to ask you is, you know, there's been a lot of talk about that idea and about this documentary being ill-timed and insensitive, et cetera, et cetera. What are your thoughts on that? And what do you think can be done in order? What would you rather have? What's the solution?
You see, I'm a trained journalist and at the same time a public relations expert. And I think they've done a bad job. That's the aids to Mr. President. They've done a bad job for the man, simply because, believe me sincerely, they've done something, because by the time we start interrogating this, they've done something that is terrible, because by saying the human side of Mr. President, they validated the music of Fela Kulapo, the Beast of No Nation. And that is not fair enough on the president, because they validated that, because when you listen to that music, when Fela was classifying our leaders in animal form. Now, what you're saying now is that you have actually admitted to what Fela said about the president, then as a general. Now you are now talking about the human side of him. And when you are even talking about the human side of him, what are you talking about? You're talking about interviewing ministers. That's the first flop in that. Two, in terms of timing, the timing is very bad. I mean, it was very bad, because the president had his own bad day. You didn't show this on that particular day. You chose a period where ordinarily, you see, the period of festivity, like the Yuletide, is always a period that politicians always look forward to, because it takes the burden of governance away from them. You understand? So people want to enjoy themselves, and it's always a break for politicians. But what did they do? Because they are not experts in this field. They decide to bring the president again into the face of the people, so that you continue to receive criticism. That's not a very good way to manage the president.
Mr. Atoye, I want to just ask you, what you're getting at, essentially, if I'm understanding you correctly, is that the president's imaging, the president's messaging system, his team, whatever the case may be, do you believe that he's being mishandled by his handlers?
Absolutely. It's professional. That's exactly where I'm trying to put it. I'm putting it in context. You see, there are good time to do some of these things, and not a time when Nigerians are going through pains, not when Nigerians are stranded all over the country trying to get transportation to their different destination, not at that point in time. And they told them, some people called them to order, they said they are going to go ahead of it, and they called the bluff of Nigerians. You know, such a situation would definitely put the president in a bad light, you know, before our Nigerians. And probably maybe the whole thing is just a kind of a contrived an arrangement. Probably maybe some people just want to look good before Mr. President, but I don't think that. And let me tell you something. The total bad side of this is the fact that ordinarily such a document should have been done by an independent, I mean Nigerians of independent mindset, saying, okay, we appreciate our president, we've seen certain things about him, we are putting this together, and we are airing. Then the presidency and his team will sit back and look at that and enjoy it and appreciate Nigerians for doing it. But because they know that Nigerians are not willing to even do that, because what the president has failed them. So they realize that when you see this kind of situation, that you see the media aid of the president are the one going ahead to put together a documentary to make the president look good, the whole essence is the fact that probably the president has failed or is failing. So these are some of the things, these are part of the things to measure.
Have we ever had a president in this country, though, have Nigerians just independently want to do a documentary for him that's not sponsored by government in some shape or fashion?
Yeah,
Have we ever seen that before?
Well, it's possible. It's possible we've seen, because I remember vividly former President Olusegun Obasanjo did a lot of things, needs, and a lot of documentaries, but I don't readily have my facts. But even if they had not done that, it means that the fact that these people are also not doing it, that means that they are not getting it right. You know, one thing Femi Adesina, that's the president, has said is that, you see, they don't want to always go into the past, they want to talk about the present. However, I also probably, maybe if I want to align with him, it means that if previous administrations have made their mistakes, then we should expect this current administration. Remember, the president started contesting since 2003. He's been around monitoring successive government, which means that it should be the best of all in terms of, you know, administration, in terms of this concern about governance.